ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 19th பாசுரம். குத்து விளக்கெரிய கோட்டுக்கால் கட்டில் மேல் மெத்தென்ற பஞ்ச சயனத்தின் மேலேறி கொத்தலர் பூங்குழல் நப்பின்னை கொங்கை மேல் வைத்து கிடந்த மலர்மார் பாவாய் திரவாய் மைத்தடங்கண்ணினாய் நீ உன் மணாளனை எத்தனை போதும் துயிலழ ஒட்டாய் காண் எத்தனை ஏலும் பிரிவாற்ற கில்லாயால் தத்துவமன்று தகவேலோரம்பாவாய். ஆண்டாள் அண்ட் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஹாவ் ரீச்ட் கிருஷ்ணாஸ் பேலஸ் அண்ட் தே ஹவ் சக்சஸ்ஃபுல்லி வோக்கன் அப் கிருஷ்ணாஸ் பேரண்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் பிரதர் அண்ட் நவ் தே ஆர் இன் த ப்ராசஸ் ஆஃப் வேக்கிங் அப் கிருஷ்ணாஸ் கான்சர்ட் நப்பின்னை. தே ட்ரை டு வேக் நப்பின்னை அப் இன் த 18th பாசுரம் பட் ஷீ டிட் நாட் கெட் அப். So these girls had a look through the window of the room. They had the liberty with Napinai and Krishna. They knew that the divine couple would not mistake these girls because after all they were their devotees and people who were very close to them. So very liberally they looked through the window and they saw that Napinai was holding a ball in her hand. And apparently Napinai and Krishna had played a ball game in which Napinai had won and was holding the ball as a mark of victory. So as these girls are now looking into the room, they see how beautiful the room is. It seems the room is decorated with beautiful lamps. Kuththu vilakkeriya, she says. Kuththu vilakku refers to the traditional auspicious lamp which is always kept in culture-based households. And it seems these lamps are always lit. Throughout the day, they were lit in those times, even at the night time. And so, Andal is describing that this room where the divine couple was lying down in the night also had kuththu vilakku, the auspicious lamp, lit there. Again, Thiruppavai being the Mangala Prabandham and Andal being Mangala Devatai, she is talking about a Mangala aspect, the auspicious aspect of this kuththu vilakku or auspicious lamp. Besides this kuththu vilakku was a beautiful ivory cot. Kottu kal kattil mel, she says. A cot made up of pure ivory. It was rich and radiant. Looking at that cot, the girls really thought that this is the cot that suits Napinai and Krishna. It is just made for great people like that. It's made from the best quality material. Kottu kal kattil mel, methendra panja shayanathin meleri. The bed on that cot was even more wonderful, it seems. She says it was pancha shayanam. Now, what do you mean by pancha shayanam? A bed having five kinds of qualities. A good bed should have five qualities, it seems. What are those qualities? Number one, it should be fragrant. We should not have a bed which is smelling of probably oil or some unwanted bad smells. It should be fragrant. So that's the first quality. Second, it should be soft. Third, it should be cool. Fourth, it should be white in color, it seems. A good bed should have white color. That's what the Shastras describe. Shastras even describe how a good bed should be. So a good bed should be white in color. And last but not the least, the bed should also be beautiful to look at. So these five attributes should be present in a bed so that a person can comfortably sleep, relax and get out of all his worldly tensions. This particular bed of Krishna was Panchashayanam, having all these qualities. And there Krishna and Napinai were sitting. And how was this Napinai? They see Napinai on this bed and they start describing her. She is so beautiful. They described her hair in the previous pasuram. Now they are describing the flowers on that hair. கொத்தலர் பூங்குழல் நப்பின்னை கொங்கை மேல் வைத்து கிடந்த மலர் மார்பாவாய் திரவாய். இட் சீம்ஸ் திஸ் நப்பின்னை ஹேட் a beautiful strand of flowers, string of flowers, which were just blossoming then. A flower is in maximum beauty when it is blossoming. So she had a string of flowers which were just blossoming. Kottalar pungulal nappinai, they say. And besides nappinai was the Lord having a broad smile and a broad chest. Kottalar pungulal nappinai kongai mel vaithu kidanda malar marbavai thiravai. They say malar marba, meaning the broad-chested one. The Lord has a broad chest for two reasons. One is, it seems he is very happy. So, as a mark of happiness, his chest has expanded in pride. The Lord is very proud to hear from these girls that his consort has won the game against him. He is very happy that Nappinai has won that ball game. And these girls have praised Nappinai as the victorious one. And so the Lord is very proud of his consort. And so they say that he is very proudly holding a broad chest. That's one reason. Another reason is the Lord has a huge space in his heart for devotees. So as a mark of accommodating any number of devotees that come to him, he is having a broad chest. He means to say that my heart is open to as many devotees as they come to me. I am open to all. You come to me and I take you into my fold. So, to show his generosity, the Lord is showing a broad chest. Malar marba vai thiravai. These girls look at the Lord's generosity and ask him, you are so generous, Lord. You want all devotees to come to you. You are ready to take them into your fold. But now you are not talking. Vai thiravai, please open your mouth, they say. Now the Lord is actually feeling so good about what the girls have told about him. They are calling him the generous one and they are saying that he should open his mouth and talk. When so many girls collectively come and ask the Lord, how can he refuse to them? So he actually starts getting up and going out. At this time, Nappinai holds his hand, it seems. And she says, wait. These people are my people. So let me talk to them first. You can come later, she says. The girls are observing this. They are able to see everything that's happening between the two of them. So looking at Nappinai, thus holding the hand of the Lord, these girls address Nappinai and say, Maitadang Kanninai, O Nappinai, the beautiful-eyed one, the one who has applied corallium to her eyes. And the one who has eyes which are as black as the bees. Maitadankanni refers to the black-eyed one. Mai means black or mai means corallium. She has applied corallium and her eyes are naturally black too. Why are the eyes of Nappinai black? Because as we had said before, black denotes compassion. Nappinai's eyes were so compassionate that they would save even the most sinful one from the wrath of the Lord. So her eyes depicted that kindness and so they were black in color. There is another beautiful reason for Nappinai's eyes being black. The Purvacharyas say that the Lord and his consort Lakshmi Devi are so involved in each other's qualities. They are so much into looking at each other, looking at each other's qualities and praising them, that they are constantly shedding their glances on one another. The Lord keeps looking at his consort, Lakshmi Devi or Nappinai, and Nappinai keeps looking at the Lord. So, it seems that the eyes of the Lord have taken up the complexion of Lakshmi Devi. What is the complexion of Lakshmi Devi? It is supposed to be golden in color. And this gold is not just the yellow gold, but it is the reddish kind of gold. So, looking at this complexion of Lakshmi Devi all the time, looking at her all the time, the Lord's eyes have become reddish in color. They are like the lotus Alvars described. So, the Lord's redness of the eye has come because he's looking at Lakshmi Devi all the time. Because she is like red gold. And Lakshmi Devi or Napinai in this case is constantly looking at the Lord, who is dark hued, who is black in color. So his color has been taken up by her eyes because she is constantly looking. That is why she has become the black eyed one. Maitadankanninai. All this the girls are describing in a single word. So much meaning they have put into it. That is Andal's greatness. She's put so much meaning into each word of ThiruppAvai that it can be commented upon for hours together. And also, she has kept it so simple that it can be commented upon in a few minutes too. That is Andal's greatness. And her gracious boon to us so that we can enjoy and attain the Lord in both ways, both in a shortcut manner or in a very elaborate way. So by saying Maitanankanninai, she conveyed so many meanings. She called out to Napinai as Maitanankanninai as she was holding the Lord's hand and not letting him go. She said, you are Maitanankanni, you are the compassionate one. So why are you not letting the Lord come out? Nee unmanalanai yettanai podum tuyilala ottai kaan. Nee unmanalanai. You are not letting your consort get up and come out. Tuyilala ottai kaan. You are not letting him get up and come out. Why? You are the one who generously gives the Lord's grace to everybody. And we are people who cannot tolerate this distance from the Lord for long. We are yearning for him. And we really want to come and attain the Lord. So you are the one who is known as Purushakara Bhutai, as we said in the last pasuram. So why are you not letting us inside? Yettana yelum pirivatra killayal. We are not able to bear this separation anymore. Please let us in. And it is your characteristic to unite us with the Lord and not prevent the Lord from coming to us, like how you are doing now. Tattvam andru. This is not your tattvam, your swarupa, your characteristic. Tattvam andru, they say. This is not your characteristic. So please refrain from this and let the Lord come out, and you also please come with him. Tattvam andru tagave lorembavai. Napinai and Krishna are listening to how beautifully these girls are talking. And not because they are not compassionate towards the girls, but only because they want to listen to the beautiful talk of these girls, both of them decide not to come out for some more time. So let us see how these girls are going to speak in the next pasuram tomorrow.